Hi, I'm J.P. Vigier. Welcome back to the Whiteboard. Today we're going to talk face-offs and face-off responsibilities. The Winnipeg Jets haven't been doing good at the face-off dot. One of the losses of Brian Little has really hurt them. The Jets are almost averaging between 39 and 40% at the face-off dot the last couple games. That's bad for several reasons. One, you're chasing the game. It's hard to get that puck back and control it. Two, you're always defending now. You have to work a whole lot harder when you're defending than when you're attacking. And thirdly, it's a loss of momentum. Now the other team's got energy, they're excited, they're controlling the play, and you're trying to gain the play back. So here we'll show an example of why it's a little bit dangerous. Here, Adam Laurie's taking a face-off against a St. Louis player. His responsibility is to tie up and not lose the face-off clean back here. Perfect world, he wins it right back here, and Tyler Myers skates into it. Tyler Myers' responsibility is to take a step here, block out the St. Louis player, help in a face-off right here, and if the puck is won, he's gonna skate into it here. Andrew Ladd, his responsibility is to take a step, help at the face-off dot, chip the puck back if he can. If he can't, he continues on to his position here. Toby Enstrom, he's supposed to help with any loose pucks in this area, chip him back so Tyler Myers can skate into it. Michael Frolik, he's a safety valve. He's gonna wait. If the faceoff is won, he comes nice and low down here to pivot. As Tyler Myers comes through here, it's a pass and the Jets are on the breakout. If there's a faceoff loss, he's gonna wait and look for any loose pucks. If the puck goes D to D like this, he's gonna come out in front this player and block the shot from coming through. It's very important, because if the puck gets here, it's dangerous. Any shot from the middle of the ice is way more dangerous than a shot from the outside. So those are the keys. And the Jets lose the faceoff on the play here, and they end up chasing the game. The period, the shift goes on in the zone for 20 or 30 seconds where St. Louis gets momentum. So it's a lot of important things there. The Jets have to do a better job of winning faceoffs. Now we're gonna show what can happen when you win a faceoff. It doesn't take long. Responsibilities, the wingers come in, take a step in front of the St. Louis players, help in the battle of the puck. As the puck goes back, now the Jets are in attack mode, right? They're not defending. St. Louis is defending. Now you'll see, as we get going, the Jets get that puck, and now they're attacking. They're on the attack instead of defending like the earlier video. The puck comes in. It's one quick pass and a great shot by Lee Stepniak. That's how quickly the game can change. That's how important faceoffs are. The Jets are going to have to be better at that. We'll have to watch on the next game. Thanks for watching The Whiteboard.